Welcome everyone to Vegetarian Cuisine with a Naturopathic Approach by Dayudusa. Our guest today is Jyoti Chawla from Bahrain, and she will be teaching us how to make suji ka halwa. And in the future, she will be teaching something called nagora and some special kind of puri that goes with it, which is a specialty of Old Delhi, Chandni Chowk. So we'll start with suji halwa today, which she's making with galachana, and next time she will teach us how to make the nagora to go with it. So welcome, Jyoti.
Thank you everyone, and welcome everyone. Chandni Chowk mein chandi ke chamach se chandu ke chacha ne chutney chatai. You know why I am telling this? Because I belong to Chandni Chowk, Delhi 6. And today our dish is also from Chandni Chowk only. Mainly halwa. In my childhood, whenever I used to go to school from my lane, very narrow lanes, and 1, 2, 3 shops, halwai shops were. They were big, like big containers only with halwa. And I used to admire that halwa always in my childhood. So let's start with our ingredients. These ingredients I am going to use with chana masala: cumin seeds, coriander powder, red chili powder. This is Kashmiri, and this is mango powder. And for halwa, I am going to take semolina with the besan and elaichi powder, cardamom seeds, sugar, and almonds. Let's talk about suji's health benefits. Suji is very rich in iron, and suji always boosts our energy. And if we talk about black chana, I have boiled and kept it there. Boiled chana soup is very healthy, and boiled chana is very rich in iron to proteins and with many minerals. Black chana is always very, very good for health. If we talk about almonds, so many health benefits from almonds. So let's go to our kitchen, and welcome to Mrs. Chawla's kitchen. So let's start our suji halwa first. I have just heated some ghee already. It's very high. So I will reduce, the temperature. So this is our suji. I'm going to add. I will just remove, because I just put it on, but it was on high heat. And this is our besan. 1 spoon with 1 cup of suji, 1 tablespoon of besan I have taken. So we will roast now this besan and suji together. And here I have kept my, I took 3 and a half cups of water, and I'm going to add the same amount of suji I took. This is brown sugar. I'm going to add in this. Same amount of suji and same amount of sugar we are taking in this. Some people, they like to put this cardamom seeds in the frying suji, but I always prefer in the water. So I'm going to add little amount of cardamom seeds. Cardamom seeds gives flavor, but suji halwa itself has very good flavor with the small amount of besan. So that's why
Jyoti, is it ghee or is it oil? And also, how much ghee?
Always we take ghee, And ghee always should be more than suji, because it should be like float. Ghee should be float in suji. If you will take very little amount of ghee and suji will be dry, the halwa taste will never be good.
Okay. So how much ghee did you put?
Three big spoons I took. Bigger than this. I took three, we call it like karchi, we can call, or big
okay,
spoon.
Okay, three karchis. Yeah. And suji was one cup, right?
Suji was one this cup. And same amount of sugar I added into the water.
And more than the same amount of ghee. Ghee should be more than suji.
Ghee should be more. Sugar should be less. If it is less also, it's fine. Because nowadays, no one likes to eat more sugar. But ghee, without ghee, halwa taste is never.
So you put more than one cup of ghee?
Didi, no, not one cup. Maybe this is half.
Okay. Okay.
Three big spoons will be half only.
Okay.
I will show you. This three spoons. This one, three spoons I took. And at the end, we will garnish our halwa with almonds. We always like only almonds in our halwa. We don't like raisins or cashews or pista, nothing. So almonds gives very good flavor and very good taste to halwa. I will just heat the pan for our chana tadka also. Chana, I will just do only tempering. I have boiled these chana already to you today, just 1 hour before. And the chana were soaked previous night. This water is boiled already, so no need to make very thick or this one. So I'm going to remove this from the heat now. This
Jyoti,
is already boiled.
Jyoti, I want to ask, water measurement is there? How much water we have to
put? Three cup. If we are taking one cup suji, three cup water. I just added a little more, but three cups are enough.
Okay.
Exactly three. What amount is suji? That's three into three will be water.
Okay.
And sugar will be always less in my case. If sugar, you can add according to your taste. Because some people, they like more sugary, more sweet. But we like up to the low
good. Good. It's less sugar. Good.
Yeah, we always like less sugar. And I will add oil, very little, like only one spoon oil I will take for chana. Some people, when I am making prashad or for ashram, I use always ghee for chana also. But today I will take just one spoon of this one, of oil, normal oil.
So when you say one spoon, you mean one karchi?
Haan, one karchi, didi. Hanji.
Okay.
So this our suji is also ready, now going to be ready. The color should be little dark, so I'm reducing the heat now because it is already brown. But I always make little dark brown, so it gives very good color to our halwa. I will shift this back. We need to cover this for let it be little cool. Then I will add water in this halwa. This suji, fried suji. Suji is done now. Very good brown color is there. So I will just leave it, and we will make our stampering for chana. 1 spoon of cumin seeds. Now I will add a little bit chili. Chili, you can. This is color for color only. So this you can reduce or increase according to your taste. And 2 spoons. This 2 teaspoons of. First, I took a little more. For 2 teaspoons of coriander powder. Now I am adding our chola chana in this black chana. Because this is chana masala, so we will not use any other thing. Some people like black pepper also, so freshly crushed black pepper we can add very little. And now I am going to add mango powder, because this we need a little bit sour. So because this is chana masala, so we have to add mango powder in this. In this, I use very, very less oil. I use very less oil in this.
Jyoti, when you put salt then? Salt?
Salt, Didi, when I boil, I added only salt. While boiling, I added to chana only salt. And rest, this dry masala, now like this. Even for prasad also, I always make chana like this.
Gayatri, we can't see Jyoti anymore. We just see Bharti's thing on there. I don't know why.
This chana is ready. Now, last, this homemade garam masala, that only this much. Pinch, I'm using only pinch. Because this is very strong.
So Jyoti, you had shown some cumin powder also, but you didn't put cumin powder.
No, Didi, coriander powder. I added coriander powder and cumin seeds.
Okay. Just the seeds. Okay.
Yeah. So our chanas are ready now, and we'll come back to our halwa. And I use always while putting water, this sugar syrup, sugary water. I always use. Just to avoid any lumps in our halwa. And we need to cover this slow heat. Actually, now I don't know how much time we have. I will put it little high. Otherwise, I always put my halwa in two or three only. Because in a very slow heat, it should cook now with the sugar and water. So now I am increased, I have increased to 5 or 6. Meanwhile, we will just put chanas in. This is ready to serve now. Unfortunately, I don't have dhania today in my fridge. And we like to eat with green chilies, always. So these chana masalas are ready. Chopped green, we always add chopped green chilies because my family, they love this whenever we cook this dry chana with green chilies. So these chanas are ready now.
Jyoti, one more question. You didn't put salt in the chana.
Didi, salt while boiling only I put salt when I was boiling.
How much chana and how much salt?
Chanas were today 300 grams and I added salt to taste only. One small spoon of chana, teaspoon of chana I added, maybe little less only, because my salt is low salt. So we are putting little more. It got switched off. So now we will and I have kept ready puris just to show this goes with this is normal wheat flour, just only wheat flour and a pinch of salt, these puris. So we have time now, we will serve one plate.
Would you serve the halwa along with the
yes,
chana?
Yes, always.
So sweet and salty together.
Yes. In future, when we will get chance, I'm going to show all the companions with halwa combination: halwa puri, halwa kachori, halwa nagori. What just now you were talking. That is made up of, we cook with suji. Suji like golgari. Yeah, with this halwa, many things accompany with halwa. When you go to Chani Chow, you will get halwa puri, halwa nagori. Nagori is made up of suji and a bit, we add a little spoon of whole purpose flour, maida. And people like halwa and kachori also. So with halwa, halwa puri, halwa bedmi. Bedmi is white dal, white pulses, coarsely grounded and add in the atta. So bedmi, like I shared that picture in our group. So that day I cooked bedmi. Bedmi is very, very tasty with aloo and halwa together. So we can eat halwa with many many things together in Chandni Chowk. And today's puri is only this simple flour, simple wheat flour. And this chana, this is like a prasad plate today. We in Navratras also, when we Mata Rani ke prasad, from my childhood we have one Kali Mata's temple. I always used to get this chana every time whenever I go to attend. I used to run to that temple, and Panditji used to give me only black chana. Even now, me and my husband, we had been to Chandni Chowk, and we get the same chana, but that is only boiled. So this is with little masala, not and very less oil. So today our halwa is a little darker, but I always make dark suji. I roast more. So see this one, like how it is leaving the spoon. There is nothing on the spoon. So our halwa is ready. Puri is ready. So now my husband will taste and let us know how the taste is.
Much turn to taste the food. Seems to be very tempting.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Neil.
Well, I'll try. Normally, when we do fasting during Navratras, she prepares this kind of chana, but normally we add some chopped chili on it. It tastes very nice with puri. So let me try this first.
In hotel also, his duty is food tasting only. At home also, he got a chance for food tasting.
Chanas are very nicely done, very well coated with the masala.
Salt is okay.
Salt is very good. Yeah. She actually, when she boils this chana, she adds salt at that time. So okay. No need to add the salt after, you know, while cooking it.
Okay.
Tastes excellent. So now is the turn for halwa.
Aloo is missing, aloo sabzi, but next time we will make another things with along with halwa.
Hmm. Wow. Very nice. It's not because she's my wife.
Oh.
Very good food. And this reminds me that I am in Chandni Chowk right now. Nice to meet you all. God bless you.
Thank you so much. Thank you, Abhi.
Thank you, Neil. And thank you, Jyoti.
Thank you, everyone.
Thank you,
for
Didi, we must say Jai Mata Di for this thali.
Absolutely.
Jai Mata Di.
Jai
Mata Di. Thank you, Diduji. Thank you, Gayatri.
Thank you.
It was very nice, Didi.
Host. Thank you so much, Gayatri Ji, for your kind seva.
Yeah,
we really must thank Gayatri because it's 6:30 in the morning here on the East Coast. Oh. And it's early for us to be doing this seva. But this week we had nobody at a later time. And Gayatri is very, very busy. And sometimes I don't get a chance to speak to her till after 11 p.m. That's how busy she is. But she still made time for this seva this week.
Thank you guys.
Very, very grateful to everyone. And thank you for taking us down your memory lane to Chandni Chowk today. And we look forward to the next time when you make Nagori.
Yes, okay. Nagori. Yeah, next time, Nagori and aloo ki sabzi.
Okay, Jyoti. Okay, Jyoti. Bye.
Okay, Didi. Bye. Bye, Didi.
Bye. Bye, Pooja.